بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا ما بعد. The author, may Allah have mercy upon him, goes on to mention the Quran is the speech of Allah. The Quran is the uncreated speech of Allah, and no one should be too weak to declare it. So this issue of claiming that the Quran is created, as you all are aware, is very serious. A great trial occurred for Ahl-Sunnah due to this issue, and the head of those who sustained great difficulty and tribulations was Imam Ahmed, may Allah have mercy upon him. During this trial, people were imprisoned, tortured, and killed. All of this was done by the Jahmiyyah and the Mu'tazila during the time of Al-Ma'mun, Wal-Mu'tasim, Wal-Wathiq. Al-Ma'mun, Wal-Mu'tasim, Wal-Wathiq. Who's Al-Ma'mun? Ma'mun is a son of who? The Ma'mun is the son of Harun al-Rashid. Harun al-Rashid, one of the great khulafa, Harun al-Rashid, rahimahullah ta'ala. You know his story with one of the kings of the Romans or the Byzantine during his lifetime, Naqfur. You know, so before they had a woman that was in charge of the Romans, and she used to pay jizya. Then Naqfur took over. He sent a letter to Harun al-Rashid. He said, this woman put you in, she made you like an eagle because the nature of the woman are weak and so on. So all that money that was given to you as a jizya, you need to give them back. And not just that, and you need to pay extra money. You know, so and otherwise I will come and take over your lands. Harun al-Rashid, when he received the letter, he turned it over and he said to his katib to write. And you know, if you're a leader, send a letter and you reply with the same one, you know, at the back of his letter, that is a sign of disrespect, that you don't consider him as nothing. So he said to his katib, write, min Harun al-Rashid, Amir al-Mu'minin, from Harun al-Rashid, the leader of the believers, ila Naqfur, kalb al-Rum, to Naqfur, the dog of the Byzantine. The answer is not what you're going to hear. The answer, what you're going to see. And then he prepared the army. And he went and he took over the land. Then Naqfur stopped paying jizya. He knew that Harun al-Rashid can't play around Harun al-Rashid. Harun al-Rashid, he used to do jihad 1 year and go to Hajj 1 year. But in the Arab world, the movies they made about him, they made him seem like he just likes women, that's it. You know, they tried to give a bad image about Harun al-Rashid, rahimahullah ta'ala, al-Khalifa Harun al-Rashid. The Shahid, Al-Ma'mun, is a son of Harun al-Rashid. Al-Ma'mun is a son of Harun al-Rashid. Likewise, Al-Mu'tasim. As for Al-Wathiq, Al-Wathiq Billah is the son of Al-Mu'tasim. Is the son of Al-Mu'tasim. So this fitna of Khalq al-Quran started by Al-Ma'mun. And Imam Ahmed rahimahu ta'ala, Ma'mun wanted to kill him. So on the way, when they were taking him and Muhammad bin Nuh, his companion, Muhammad bin Nuh, he made a dua. He said, oh Allah, if the Quran is uncreated, don't let me see the face of Al-Ma'mun. Then the subhanAllah, someone came and he said, Ma'mun has died. Then he said that they took them back to Baghdad. They took them back to Baghdad because Ma'mun was not in Baghdad. It was another city, Al-Amuriya, in a different city. The Shahid, Al-Mu'tasim, he was a warrior, fighter. You know, he was not really involved in his philosophy. Al-Ma'mun, he was involved in his philosophy. He is the first person to bring these books of the Greek philosophers and translate them. So I said, even before him, but he was very amazed with this type of ilm, ilm al-kalam and falsafa. And remember, he was surrounded with a lot of Mu'tazila, Al-Ma'mun. The head of them was Bishr bin Ghiyath al-Marisi and Ahmed bin Abi Duad. Bishr bin Ghiyath al-Marisi and Ahmed bin Abi Duad. Ahmed bin Abi Duad, he is the one who debated with the Imam Ahmed bin Hanbal al-Shaybani. And Al-Mu'tasim rahimahullah ta'ala, may Allah forgive all of them. Because his Ma'mun, he took it back. Wallahu a'lam, but Al-Mu'tasim, he was not involved at all. Just because his brother said to him to bring closer to you, Ahmed ibn Abi Duad, listen to him. But because Ahmed ibn Abi Duad said to Al-Mu'tasim, he said he's a shab, Ahmed ibn Hanbal. When he saw him, he said, you told me he's a shab. He said, no, I mean shab in his aql. You know? But of course, when the fitna started, a lot of scholars rejected it first. Then a lot of them accepted it. The scholars of Baghdad accepted out of fear. And then Al-Wathiq, then Mu'tasim, then Al-Wathiq, when Al-Wathiq came, Al-Wathiq was worse. He was like his father, Afwan, his uncle, Al-Ma'mun. Rather, he was worse. Then after him, who? Al-Mutawakkil ala Allah. Al-Mutawakkil ala Allah, he was upon the Sunnah. He was someone who revived the Sunnah. And Imam Ahmed, rahimahu ta'ala, even though he was tortured, many scholars were killed. Al-Buwaiti was killed, rahimahu ta'ala. Many scholars were killed. Al-Qawariri, one of them as well. Ahmed ibn Nasr al-Khuza'i. Ahmed ibn Nasr al-Khuza'i. May Allah have mercy upon him, was killed. Ahmed ibn Nasr al-Khuza'i, he started enjoying good with the evil. And when they captured him, the reason Ahmed ibn Nasr al-Khuza'i, they couldn't do nothing to him in the beginning, because his forefathers were the defenders and the fighters and one of the heads of the or those who started Ad-Dawla al-Abbasiyya. So his tribe was very close to al-Abbasiyyin, you know, very close to the Khilafa. So al-Wathiq used to overlook Ahmed ibn Khuza'i, used to speak out openly, you know, that Ahmed ibn Hanbal is being oppressed and so on. Then he started enjoying good from the evil. And he did not rebel against the leader, as some Khawarij should say. He didn't. He was just enjoying good from the evil. They captured him. The word says, forgot about everything. Just, is the Quran created? He said, no, it's not created. He cut off his head, he killed him. He beheaded him, killed him. And Ahmed ibn Nasr al-Khuza'i was one of the great scholars of Ahl al-Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And then the time of Al-Mutawakkil ala Allah, that's when the fitna was removed and Ahl al-Sunnah started speaking openly. You know, Allah humiliated Ahmed ibn Abi Duad. He became very sick, he couldn't move. You know, subhanAllah. Now, that's why Al-Bayhaqi mentioned, كان الحكم كان الخلفاء على مذهب السلف الى وقت المأمون. That the khulafa, all of them were upon the way of the salaf until al-ma'mun. Before that, all of them, al-umawiyyin, and then some of the abbasiyyin, and until al-ma'mun. Then alhamdulillah al-mutawakkil came, and as we have mentioned, but it was a big fitna. Rather, as the mu'arrikhun mentioned, the historians mentioned, that when the prisoners that were taken by the Byzantines or the other people, the non-Muslims, when the Muslims went to war with them, before exchanging the prisoners, Ahmed ibn Abi Du'ad, akhzahu Allah, he used to say, you have to test them. He told Ma'mun, tell the soldiers before exchanging with any prisoner, you have to test that prisoner. What do you say about the Quran? Is it created or not? SubhanAllah. If he says it's not created, they say keep him. So it's a big fitna. Not like how Muhammad Hijab tried to make it seem. Muhammad Hijab is not Salafi. He's not open. He's not Athari. He's Khuza'bali. Khayt ibn the business. You know, this person. He's a person of bid'ah, mubtada. No doubt. Qulat of bid'ah. Defender of bid'ah, hate Ahl Sunnah, attack against Ahl Sunnah. Watch his videos. No videos against Ash'aris, no videos against Sufiya, no videos against Maturidis, but they have specific channel against Ahl Sunnah Jama'ah. SubhanAllah. Specific channel based upon lies and slander. You know, SubhanAllah, look at that. So, mocks Ahl Sunnah, you know? So he tried, he said, no, it wasn't that bad. Even the non-Muslims, he said, it was bad, wasn't it? He said, no, not a lot of the people. Yeah, a lot of people were killed, yeah. You don't know about Tariq? Even the story of Abdul Aziz bin Yahya al-Kinani, rahimahullah ta'ala, when he was in Mecca, and he said, I heard that people cannot speak about the Quran in Baghdad. So he took his son and he went. And he said, it is a book, if you you should get a book, Kitab al-Hida, Kitab al-Hida. It's been checked by Al-Allama Nasir, Ali ibn Nasir al-Faqihi, Hafidhullah ta'ala wa rahimah. May Allah preserve him, Sheikh Nasir al-Faqihi. Bin Nasr, his name Ali, Bin Nasr al-Faqihi. The Shahid, he said, I went, and no one speaks about this issue. Big fitna. He said, I was praying, I said to my son, let's pray Jumu'ah. Because back in those days, there's masajid and there's al-jami'ah. Al-jami'ah mean, is a masjid when everyone comes to pray Jumu'ah. Back in those days, not every masjid pray Jumu'ah, no. All masajid stop and everyone goes to the jami'ah. And the Khalifa leads the prayer, or Khalifa appoints someone. So he went to the jami'ah of Baghdad and he said to his son, as soon as the Imam finishes after Jumu'ah, you stand up and ask me, Ya Abdul Aziz, what do you think about the Quran? Is it created or not? You know? Because he wants to defend Sunnah. So he went and he said, so his son told him, Ya Abdul Aziz, is the Quran created? He said, it's not created. He said, before I finished the answer, the police came and arrested me. They took him away. He said, clearly you're not from here. But he said, Abdul Aziz bin Hilkinani, he said, the reason I did it, because I wanted the soldiers to capture me and take me to the Khalifa to debate Mushbir Ghiyath al-Marisi in front of the Khalifa. So they told him, we're going to take you to the Khalifa today. So Monday they came and took him. And so anyway, they took him to the Khalifa and we'll finish next time. The rest of the story. The story finished next time, inshallah. Now we're going to go for the, now we're just istidrad. Just istidrad this one. That's not the us of the mas'ala. Anyway, so they took him and debated And the shahid is that it was a big fitna. And people were not allowed to speak about it. And to know the story full, you have to go back to the book and read it. Anyway, so he debated with Bashmaghiyat al-Marisi. And he defeated him in debate. You know, alhamdulillah. And they said, Al-Ma'moon is a nice discussion, nice debate. A lot of fawa'id, a lot of benefits. You know, subhanAllah. Even they said when he entered, before he entered upon the Khalifa, he said, I become scared. Because you're going to be the Khalifa. Who is the Khalifa? One of the Khalifa that ruling the half of the world. Half the world's under him. And he said, I got scared. Then I said to the soldiers, before I go inside, can you let me pray two rak'ahs? And one of the soldiers said to him, listen, don't fear. Put trust in Allah. Put trust in Allah. So he prayed two rak'ahs and he entered. He said, as soon as I entered upon the Khalifa, Al-Ma'mun, either is Ahmed and Abi Duad, or one of the Mu'tazila, they mocked him because he was not good looking. They mocked him. So he said to the Khalifa, while he was sitting on the Khalifa said, may Allah curse the person who fixed. There was something wrong with the gate, one of the doors or the windows or the gate. May Allah curse him. May Allah curse him. Look how he fixed it. Or look how he made it. He said, yeah, Khalifa, why don't you not curse? Why you did not curse the door, but you cursed the one who made it? He said, because the door did not make itself. He said, but your wazir here, your minister, he mocked me. But I never created myself, Allah created me. So wal'iyadu billah is mocking who? Wal'iyadu billah min dhalik, you see? So Khalifa started laughing because he knew this hujjah against him. Subhanallah. Then the Khalifa asked him, he said, yeah, Abdul Aziz, where are you from? He said, I'm from Mecca. He said, do you know people from Mecca? He said, I know everyone in Mecca, except those who come from Hajj and leave. But everyone I know, their tribes, everyone, even I know your tribe here, I mean, Mu'mineen. Then Alhamdulillah, of course, debate is a book. I'm not going to say everything is a debate. But Alhamdulillah, there was a lot of fawa'id, a lot of benefit. The Shahid, that Alhamdulillah, Abdul Aziz bin Al-Kinani refuted him, exposed the ignorance of Bashbaghiyat al-Marisi. And Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah, did not rebel. He did not start writing a book about the mistakes of Al-Ma'mun or Al-Wathiq or Al-Mu'tasim. And they mentioned this story, Baqiyy ibn Makhlid. Baqiyy ibn Makhlid from the ulama of Al-Andalus. Baqiyy ibn Makhlid from the ulama of Al-Andalus. He traveled from Andalus all the way to Baghdad to seek ilm from Ahmed ibn Hanbal. He came in a time when Ahmed ibn Hanbal was banned. He was not allowed to teach. He's not even allowed to leave his house. Look at the fitna, subhanAllah. Even to go pray in the masjid, he was not allowed. He has to stay at home. So Baqiyy ibn Makhlid from Andalus to Baghdad, the months. So he came and he was asking. Then Baqiyy ibn Makhlid, his musnad, is big, way bigger than the Muslim Imam Ahmed. But it's been lost. So Baqiyy ibn Makhlid is asked, where is Ahmed? They said he cannot teach, he's been imprisoned or put in his house, he's not allowed to leave. He said, Tayyib, he went to his house in North Door. He said, yeah, Imam, he said, I'm coming from Maghrib. The Maghrib that time, where is it? Andalus, Algeria, Morocco, Tunisia, Libya, Mauritania. He said, I'm coming from the Maghrib. He said, okay, what you do every time? Come every day, but wear the garment of a beggar. Someone you come in to beg and you ask for money. And every time you come, I'll give you one hadith. He's begging for what? For hadith. So every time he comes, he tells him one hadith. When Allah removed the fitna of Khalq al-Qur'an and al-Mutawakkil, may Allah have mercy upon him, removed it. Now Imam Ahmed was allowed to teach in the masjid. Not just that. Al-Mutawakkil, before he puts anyone in charge of the government, either being qadi, judge, minister, he will ask the opinion of Imam Ahmed. What do you think about him? Should I look how Allah raised him? وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. The outcome is for the pious ones. So Imam Ahmed used to sit down in the masjid and teach, and he used to say to Ibn Makhlid, you come close to me and sit next to me. You are the true definition of student of knowledge. See, Allah, subhanAllah, Ibn Makhlid. May Allah have mercy upon him. So this is a fa'idah that the ulama mentioned about, look, subhanAllah, seeking ilm. So, as Sheikh Rabi'a ta'ala said, the good end would be for his previous, his pious servant. Ahmed exerted immense patience, preserving upon imprisonment, torture, and severe burdens that even the mountains will not be able to bear. So Allah raised him. Allah raised him. And the book of Allah and the Sunnah indicate that the Quran is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know, Muhammad, I'm not sure if you've seen a clip of Muhammad Hijab has been circulating. Even some Asha'ira are using it. He said, you see Allah's hand? You know, shouting, screaming, talking about Allah's hand. And the miskeen, you know, you can see this person, Jahil. You know, he's been raised by social media and debating. You know, read the book of the Salaf, read Ibn Khuzayma. Read the Imam of the Sunnah. وَنُثْبِتُ لِلَّهِ لِيَدَيْنِ. We affirm Allah's hands. You see, if you tell your child Allah's hand, his hand, no, you're kadab. I read the Quran when I was young, I never fought Allah's hand like my hand. أَنْتَ لِأَنَّكَ إِشْ فَيْلَسُوفُ مُبْتَدِعُ. You're a person of innovation, misguidance. That's why you have that disgusting mentality. You've been poisoned by this disgusting misguidance. But if you're عَقْلُ وَالسَّلِيمُ وَقَلْبُ سَلِيمُ, you will not say that. I never in my life read the Quran when I was a child, and I fought Allah's hand like my hand. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. And even if that, for the sake of argument, if the child misunderstood it, so we change the verse of Allah. I mean, they shouldn't misunderstand some verse in the Quran. Like my friend, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تُسَعِرْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ. He thought تُسَعِرْ خَدَّكَ means to kiss. So if someone wants to kiss him, a man, he said, no, Allah said, وَلَا تُسَعِرْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ. I said, no, that doesn't mean that. وَلَا تُسَعِرْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ mean, don't not disrespect, not disrespect mean, don't not turn away from people while speaking to you out of arrogance, you know? Do you understand? But so are we going to blame the verse? Look, this mentality, subhanAllah. Yeah, and always, Ahlul Sunnah Jama'ah, when they speak about Allah's attribute, what they say, there is nothing lack unto him. And the reason they give examples here, Muhammad Hijab, to understand, because when the Sahaba were pure, Tabi'in were pure, they didn't need to clarify. But when the people of doubt start bringing doubt against it, so the ulama of the Salaf, the imma of the Salaf, Ibn Khuzaymah and other them, start giving examples to clarify. Doesn't mean Allah said a hand because the people did. So you see what happened? Before, Prophet, Nabi alayhi salam never had to clarify to Sahaba what is the hand of Allah. Look, Arabic, everyone understand the meaning of it. Kayfiyah, Allah knows it. Allah mentioned the face. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the saq, the shin, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentioned the foot, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the web of His Majesty. There is nothing like unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, if you say that he's a human being, so if I said to you, I have an ant, university ant, ant has a face, and the ant has the legs, you're going to think ant's a human being. That shows you, you're ahmaq. So anything that I've been described, that you prove our points. You just prove our points, alhamdulillah. Doesn't mean because you describe something, and they share the same name, therefore it's the same reality. Subhanallah.
The clock has a hand.
Yeah, the clock has a hand and a face and a back. To Muhammad Hijab, he's a human being now. To him, he's going to be an Adam. He's going to think, if you've never seen a clock, and he said, I have a clock. He has a face, he has a back, and he has a hand. And maybe even some crook, they have legs. And if they have legs, say, yeah, you have incense then. But in Adam, you have a trunk. Miskeen. You just proved our point, subhanAllah. Naam? تشابه الأسماء لا معنى ليس معناها تشابه الحقائق. Doesn't mean because the same names and therefore the reality is the same. Allah clearly there is nothing like unto Him. Nothing like unto whatever you try to resemble Allah, there is nothing like unto Him. So Al-Sunnah, when they speak about Allah's attributes, and guess what? Muhammad Hijab took it from who? From Yas al-Qadi. Yas al-Qadi said that before him. You know, Yas al-Qadi, the trumpet of the enemies of Islam. May Allah save us and protect us. And may Allah guide us and guide them. Subhanallah. That's why I say, Buqa min abwaq al-mustashriqeen is a trumpet from the trumpets of the Orientalists. Now, Yas al-Fadi, alhamdulillah, the brothers gave him a good name. Empty, not Qadi. Qadi is a judge. He's an empty person. Muhammad Hijab, he wants to criticize him, start praising him, more criticizing him. Miskeen. The Shaykh, barakallahu feekum, read the book of the Salaf. Leave all these disgusting books of philosophy to understand why they had to clarify that. You know, yas'alunaka 'an al-mahit, Allah clarified to them. You see? So when there's some issues not clear to Sahaba, Prophet ﷺ clarified. After, when there were some issues not clear to some Muslims, due to people of misguidance, bringing doubt against it, the Salafs are clarifying to them that we can give you, in the, just among the creation, you share the same names, but in the reality is different. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. The best example belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. Allah is calamity and mocking the Asha'ira. Asha'ira, you are proof of misguidance. Your aqidah is corrupted. Abu Hassan Ash'ari left you. You know, using Muhammad Hijab, you might just use David Wood as well. You figure because you're using Muhammad Hijab. Muhammad Hijab ليس بأثري. لا من قريب ولا من بعيد. He has never done al-athar. Not from close distance or far distance. When you come to this bab, let me be specific. In terms of this bab, of asma wa sifat, is mutalakhbat. Mutalakhbat. خير ده بيت business. بارك الله فيكم. You know, so this brother, we spoke to him, advised him, but he's on a mission to lie against Ahl-Sunnah. They have a specific channel to slander Ahl-Sunnah Jama'ah. But not a channel for against Sufiya, Ash'aris, Maturidis, Naqshbandis, Ikhwanis, Qutbis, Sururis. No, none of that. Because what Ahl-Sunnah, he knows, is they're blocking them. Like the enemies of Islam, even though they have different backgrounds, they come against Islam because they know Islam is blocking the agenda. From the Muslims, within the Muslims, Al-Bid'ah come together against Salafiyun. Subhanallah. Naam, so the Quran is the speech of Allah. Why Muhammad Hijab, Hadak Allah? Why did Salaf have written, why did Salaf wrote books in Aqa'id? Why? علي بن أبي طالب قال العلم كان نقطة فكثره الجهال. العلم knowledge was a dot. What made it a lot is the ignorant ones. What does that mean? When the ignorant ones start speaking, the scholars clarify. نعم. They had to clarify because they saw a Muslim layman are listening to جهال. كبش من غيات غياث المريسي كأحمد بن أبي دؤاد جعد بن درهم جاب بن صفوان. So the ulama starts writing a books clarifying the عقيدة. And Imam Ahmed gave an example, يا مسكين, في ردع الجهمية, when they try to say affirming Allah's a different attribute that will indicate there's different gods. So you have many gods now. Look to his jahl. So he, Imam Ahmed said in his book, he said, the palm tree, there's the jada, naam, and there's the leaves. How many palm tree there is now? And there's the height, it's tall. So if I say I have palm tree, that is very tall, thick. How many tree I have? Well, but to your Jamies, I have three now. Yeah, Jamies have three leaves each. With a leaf, I have four now. So Imam Ahmed gave an example, analogy to clarify. And if you did, and you know, Muhammad Hijab, he's heavily influenced by Asqadi. See, Asqadi, he goes like, my humble opinion, no, there's disaster coming after that. When you know, when you hear Yes Al-Qadi Al-Fadi says, in my humble opinion, just hold your head. Calamity is coming. Muhammad Hijab said, in my opinion, calamity is coming after. Subhanallah. Allahu Akbar. Allah al-afu al-afiyah. The نعم. So there is many proofs. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, قل لو كان البحر مدادا لكلمات ربي لنفد البحر قبل أن تنفذ كلمات ربي ولو جئنا بمثله مددا. Say, O Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام to man, say, O Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام to mankind, if the sea were ink for writing the words of my Lord, surely the sea would be exhausted before the words of my Lord would be finished, even if you brought another sea like it for its aid. From Allah's speech are the books that were sent down for the rectification and guidance of mankind, to save them from misguidance and for other aims and goals that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. This is from the mercy, wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His Lordship, that He sends down revelation to His messengers, alayhi salatu salam, for the rectification. You know, and likewise, the speech of Allah, which is al-kawni, when Allah decrees something in His kawn, there is al-kalam al-shar'i wal-kalam al-kawni. Kalam al-shar'i, like the commandments in the Quran, in the Sunnah, the revelation, hadith al-Qudsi, likewise the books before and the revelations before, and al-Kawni, there is the when Allah decrees something in His universe or in His creation to be within His creation. The Quran is uncreated speech of Allah, which Allah spoke with subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah spoke to Musa directly. وَإِذْ نَادَى رَبُّكَ, and when your Lord called out to Musa, nada, calling out, does not occur except with the letters and of ways that is befitting to Allah. Look, they said it clearly. So look, the ulama, when they mention Allah's attribute, they say the way befits His Majesty. And you know, there's a Christian channel, you know, those who try to utilize my video when I spoke about this brother from America. These guys, they try to use Muhammad Hijab's video as well. I mean, these guys, they're dying. I mean, Christianity is dying. Like, go help your Christianity, man. You know, subhanAllah, because they know Christianity is dying. You know, Christians now, side points, is dying. Christians, instead of going try to help Christianity, they're attacking the Muslims. You know, because you cannot explain Christianity to the people. So why are you attacking Islam? So this channel of Christians, day and night just against Islam. They say they're there to teach Christianity, but they don't teach Christianity at all. So, you know, regardless of what they use, they're just hasadan, they're jealous of Islam. Alhamdulillah, they can see Islam's growing. Alhamdulillah. Anyway, so Allah's attributes, we affirm it according to His, the way befit His Majesty. You know, regardless of what you, you cannot, no one knows the haqiqa of Allah's name and attributes, I mean the reality, how it is, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we know it's the ma'na, you know, the general, but not to explain it in details, because now to say how, you have to attribute something. Tayyip? Now we need a hand. Sawakum. You say a hand. Now we say a hand. Okay. Now tell me how this hand look. You have to tell me whose hand. The hand of the clock. The hand of the door. The hand of your hand. The hand of this animal. The animal. Do you understand? There's general. There's a general meaning and a specific. Or description. So when it comes specific, now to describe it, you have to attribute it to something. Do you understand that? So when we say Allah has a hand way before His Majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah already said to us in the Quran clearly, explicitly, وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. There is nothing like unto Him. هَلْ تَعْلَمُ لَهُ سَمِيًّا. Do you know anyone that's similar to Him? There's no one similar to Him. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. There's nothing like unto Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And is the all hearing, the all seeing. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, anyone that said the Quran is speech of a human being, his place will be in Jahannam. إِنَّهُ فَكَّرَ وَقَدَّرَ فَقُتِلَ كَيْفَ قَدَّرَ ثم قتل كيف قدر ثم نظر ثم عبس وبصر ثم أدبر واستكبر فقال إن هذا إلا سحر يؤثر إن هذا إلا قول البشر سأصليه سقر وما أدراك ما سقر لا تبقي ولا تذر لواحة للبشر. Until the end of the ayat. Verily he thought and plotted. So let him be cursed, how he plotted. And once more, let him be cursed, how he plotted. Then he thought, then he forewent and looked in a bad-tempered way. Then he turned back and was proud. Then he said, this is nothing but magic from the old, of the old. This is nothing but the word of a human. This statement of who? Who said that? نعم بارك الله فيك الوليد بن المغيرة الوليد بن المغيرة الوليد بن المغيرة is the father of خالد رضي الله عنه وارضاه الوليد بن المغيرة أبو الوليد is كنيا because خالد بن الوليد his brother became Muslim before him his name الوليد so before the Hajj time they came together in the place called DAARUSSUNNAH. It's a place where they gather all together, the leaders, the heads, the elites of the Quraysh. And they said, Hajj is soon. So all of us, we have to unite upon something about this man. What should we say to the Arabs about him? You know, just as say Majnoon said, no, it's not. Sahib, no. Kahid, not. So everyone's giving opinion and Wa ibn al-Mughira is saying he's choosing which one. Then he said no. Then Abu Jahl said to him, okay, you tell us what should we say? Then he said, innahu. No, before that, it's not praying the Quran. إنه لحلاوة أو what is the word that he used? Allah I forgot the word is but he start praising the Quran start praising the Quran then he said يعلى ولا يعلى عليه that is raised but nothing can raise above it so he They said, you want us to go out and tell the Arabs that? And then, so we are calling to him then? So he start thinking. That's, look how the Quran. إِنَّهُ فَكَّرَ وَقَدَّرَ Verily he thought. What he should say? Then he plotted. Then he thought again. Then he plotted. Then he said, it's just magic. Just tell them his speech is a magic. Can cause people to divide. To be divided. You can divide between the husband and the wife, the father and the son, and so on. There's narration that even his son told him off. He said, oh, my father, you know what you said is not true. And they know what you said is not true. They knew there were people of Lugha. That is not Kalam of Bani Adam. That's why it's Sa'uslihi Saqar. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا سَقَرْ That will lead him and will make him taste سَقَرْ وَلَيَّذُ بِاللَّهِ The statement of man, so you know, it's back of my head the a beautiful statement what he said. صدق لك هو كذوب but he is the way he described the Quran. Now, anyway, the statement of mankind is created. So Allah threatened him with a severe punishment. This is slander in the Quran, saying that it's magic or that it is the statement of a man. This is lowering and demeaning the Quran, which is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, this is the Quran, the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sent for guidance of mankind. And it's not created as for the Mu'tazila, the Jahmiya, the Batiniya. The Rafida, Rafida, ya akhwa. You know, I will repeat again. I haven't seen people that love shirk like a Rafida. Few day laymen, maybe masakin, but even among the laymen, they love shirk and they hate la ilaha illallah. This is seriously. Go to next Rafidi and see. Say la ilaha illallah. He will say ya Ali. It's like, imagine you are saying something which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create mankind for. He's not happy with it. So I don't know how people accept a raft, Shi'ism. Raf, alhamdulillah, my neighbor, he was a Shi'i, he became Sunni. Alhamdulillah. See, I left it. Full of shirk. There's no Ya Allah. Just Ya Ali is Allah to them. Subhanallah. Rafida, Shia and Khawarij and all different groups, they differ concerning the speech of Allah. All eventually arriving at the belief that Allah does not speak. Even the Asha'ira were influenced by the Mu'tazila. The first generation of Asha'ira used to say, speech is a characteristic that exists with Allah. But the Quran is not actual speech, but rather a narration of his speech. It's not a word, letters or a voice, but Allah did not speak. So Asha'ira, they say this speech is a characteristic that exists with Allah. But the Quran is not actual speech. They say ibara. You know, it's ibara. But rather a narration of his speech. It's not a word, letters or a voice. But Allah did not speak. This Quran is not his speech. We ask Allah for safety and protection from falling into such things. Allahumma ameen. But sadly, from the later generations of Asha'ira are those who blatantly say the Quran is created. Yeah, the later one, like the Asha'ira of our time, a lot of them are Sufiya. Call it shirk as well. Istighatha bi ghayrillah. But the early Asha'aris, they were not falling into shirk in Uluhiya. But a lot of them are Sufiya now, Asha'ira. Now, the Quran is the uncreated speech of Allah, and the same for Allah's speech is uncreated. These people, when they began this fitna, saying the speech of Allah, Allah created it without place. And they say it is the speech of Allah, but it is, as we say, the she camel of Allah. So they say, yes, the Quran is speech of Allah, but not actual, his attributes, like the she camel. I'm like the she. When Allah says, Naqat Allah wa suqiyah, Allah attributes the Naqa to himself. But the Naqa is not attribute of Allah. The Naqa exists by itself. So they say speech. Some say Allah created it in the air, and Jibreel took it, or in Jibreel, then Jibreel conveyed it. You know? So we say the Quran is speech of Allah, is not created. and both the wording and the meanings. A person might say this fa'ida, our Sheikh Salah mentioned that, Hafidhahu Ta'ala said, in the beginning of the fitna, Imam Ahmed used to say, anyone said the Quran is created or not, no one should say that. Should not speak about it. Why? Because it's not before the fitna starts. Afro. Why? Because there's no need to speak about this issue. But when the fitna started, because some Asha'ira, they will bring you the early kalam Ahmed. Because the Salaf used to hate speaking about something that's not there. Like, you know, that's why they dislike this type of debate. Debating about something which both of you have no knowledge, leave it. Khalas, leave it. Why are you getting into this kalam? Like Ash'ari came to me, speaking Sunnah, and he said, so you affirm Allah as a hand? I said, yeah. And he's like, I said, we know the meaning of the hands. Even Allah mentioned, he will grasp the earth, when Nabi alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith is in Bukhari, about the Yehud, when they said, Prophet, Allah will hold this type of creation with one finger, the other finger, Prophet smile, as approval. We know the meaning of it, but the reality, we don't know. You know, this belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The knowledge of that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah already told us there's nothing like unto him. So the shahid, he came to me and then he said, so you see, he has the limbs? I said, brother, why did the Quran say has the limbs? He said, no. I said, why are you talking like that? I said, be suffice. What would the Quran suffice? What suffice itself? Why with his limbs he has this? I said, what do you mean by limbs? Explain to me, what is limbs? Like human beings, what is kalam? You know, look, it's like you want to correct Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, billah. You think that's missing? Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us what we need to know? But you think, no, we need to know more? Has Allah described himself, khalas. Why do you have to, limbs, is it fingers, has it has a nose, or what is it, looks like that? Because why? You've been poisoned. But what the Salaf said, Allah has an attribute which is dirty, an attribute ma'nawi, attribute dirty like the head, the face, ma'nawi like mercy and so on. We affirm it the way of His Majesty, and there is nothing like unto Him. So if you say a cloak has a hand, and has a face, and has a back, and has a feet, to Muhammad Hijab is what? Human being. That's what only, you know, no, it's not a human being. This is just creation. Subhanallah. The shaykh, barakallahu fikum, we affirm because Allah mentioned in the Quran. And the Sahaba, they never ask. So we affirm it the way the Quran, Sahaba, and the Salaf understood it. So I told him, I said, Akhi, look, suffice, man. Yakfi, Akhi, this kalam. متفلسفة. You know, سبحان الله. الحمد لله يسأل أخي اللي يقول لك السلام عليكم take care of yourself. But suffice yourself what Quran and the Sunnah mentioned and what the Salaf were suffice with. You know? Now, if you're going to refute them, then yeah, like Ibn Taymiyyah did went in details to refute them because they were causing fitna. But me and you, what we're going to talk like that? نعوذ بالله من ذلك. Because he claimed that, he said, yeah, I affirm the hand. I don't make tafweed. Tafweed mean, we don't know the meaning. We know the meaning, but we make tafweed of al-kayfiyya, ليس of al-ma'na. Al-kayfiyya mean how. So the Quran is speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is not created. Allah said, إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُ إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَنْ يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Verily His command, when He intends a thing, is only that He says to it, be and it is. That's why the Mu'tazila, Ahmed ibn Abi Du'ad, when debates Imam Ahmed said, Allah said, أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ. أَلَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ. So Allah differentiated between His commandments and His creation. And the Quran from Allah's commandments is not from Allah's creation. You know? Look, Imam Ahmed rahimahu ta'ala. Because Allah differentiates ala lahu al-khalqu wal-amr. Is enough for Allah that indeed the creation belongs to Allah and the commandments. And from Allah's commandment, kun. That's why when the Al-Mu'tazila tried to use Jesus, they said, Isa, Allah said, kalimatu, has created. Yeah. Ahmed said, Allah clarified it. Inna mathala Isa inda Allahi kamathali Adam khalaqahu min ish? Min turabin. Thumma qala lahu kun fayakun. The similitude of Jesus with Allah is like Adam. Allah created him with kun, not his kun. He was created by the word of Allah. No, he's the actual word of Allah. Allah clarified it clearly. Alhamdulillah. And he also mentioned, and nothing of Allah's attribute or his speech is created. That's why we say, Allahu al-awwalu bi asma'ihi wa sifatihi. Allah is the first. Be. We don't say wa. You don't say Allah al-awwal wa asma'uhu wa sifatuhu. No. Allah al-awwal bi asma'ihi wa sifatihi. Allah is the first with his names and attributes. There's nothing before him. He's the first and there's nothing before him. He's the last and there's nothing after him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jalla jalaluhu. So, also be cautious of debating with anyone who has innovated concerning this affair. Notice how Imam Ahmed is placing emphasis on this issue. But when he, radiallahu anhu, needed to debate, he debated. For example, he debated Ibn Abi Du'ad and other than him, when it was a necessity and the person was seeking da'wah and the truth. Or anyone who says his recitation is created or other than this, and whoever hesitate in this matter and say, I do not know whether it's created or not, created. So he's warning against this type of people. And we carry on next week, inshallah ta'ala. Stop here. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وسلم تسليما كثيرا بارك الله فيكم وجزاكم الله خيرا. نعم الأمير رومان my brothers and sisters, the first of the Hijjah tomorrow. So you can't, if you go to slaughter, don't cut your nails, don't touch nothing from your beard, your mustache, your hair, your pubic hair, your armpits, نعم, until the night of Al-Eid, meaning that the night before the Eid. You know, Prophet does a Sunnah. And the first sentence of the Hijjah, inshallah, Jumu'ah will give khutbah about it. To the righteous actions. Increase. There's many virtues about it. And you know, the Prophet never said fast, by the way. But one of the righteous actions, one of the actions that belong to Allah, is fasting. But you can fast, give charity, read the Quran, take care of the parents, take care of your wives, take care of your neighbors. You know, there's other ways of doing righteous actions, visiting the marid, the sick people, you know, dhikr of Allah, barakallahu feekum.
So is it don't cut your nails and hair if you want to physically do it yourself, or?
Shambas said something. Anyone remember Shambas? Yeah, Shambas. But if someone else is doing it for him, I read the fatwa share, but I will check for you. Barakallahu feekum.